beautifully. You see, he had Mercado got down there in a hurry, and he had to bounce it. So good hustle all the way around. But Santana able to beat it out, and that goes a long way. Let's see if they can capitalize. Jordan Luplow, the batter. Back in the lineup with another left-handed starter. Luplow batting 299 over his last 25 games with 6 doubles, 3 homers, and a dozen runs driven in. They did a nice job. Got to beat this one out now. Here's one on the first. It's close. They call it up. The inning is potentially over.
Fiddlestick. Bang, bang.
We'll see what the verdict is. The Indians got a challenge. They might get a run and tie the game here. Oh, yeah. That foot is down on the base. I think he did. They may have to poke it to him back. When I first saw it, I thought they just got him. But that foot hits down. Yeah, I think they're going to be safe. I would be surprised. What the key is, you saw the bag move because it looked like his foot came down almost at the very front edge of the bag.
This is new.
You can see that's where you're supposed to hit it. That's exactly where you're supposed to hit the base, with your toe right at the front part, right where he hits it. And then next thing you know, you follow through. So I think it's going to get overturned. Look at it. Watch the front foot hit the very front part of that base. Yeah. That's how you run the bases right there. And it was a quick one. He's safe. Yes, indeed. So,
safe.
We'll get it, and they'll tie,
overturn.
So great hustle. First by Santana.
Yes.
And then by Luplow. Big O. Because that's what kept the inning going. Was Santana hustling to make it only one out. And then another fielder's choice. They're able to score. And we have a tie game. So.
Yes! What?
So each team
fiddlesticks.
And we're tied moving to inning number 2. There's a reason the avocados are so big and admired.
Big avocados have more healthy oil, more flavor, and more fruit. So they make more guac. Because when you're out of guac, the party takes a dip. That's why the avocados are so big and admired.
In the summertime, when the weather is hot, you can see.
pitcher, number one, Indians out. See if Shane Bieber can get back on track here after walking two in the first inning. And walking home a run for Kansas City, although that was questionable. Nicky Lopez leads off. Just doesn't have a feel for that slider yet, but he'll keep working. He still has a very good curveball. Maybe he can try that changeup on some of the left-handed hitters from Kansas City. That tells you right there, he felt
that's
he should have
caught
the first one. That one was a little lower. It was about head high, but I'll tell you what. Talk about enjoying yourself on the field. There it is.
Whoa, what a catch.
Look at that. I caught it. Reminding us all once again, they may be grown men, but it's still a little boy's game. But it's a humbling experience. He knew he should have caught the first one. He was surprised, but he's making fun of himself. But here is Bubba Starling. Kansas City have been waiting a long time for this young man. Foul off. Bubba Starling was the fifth overall pick back in 2011. And to say his minor league career was a struggle would be an understatement. As he takes a call third. That's the third strikeout for Shane Bieber, and there are two down in the inning. Salvador Perez's absence has hurt the Royals, would be a major understatement. I mean, this guy, not only is he kind of viewed as the glue, the heart and soul, the captain, whatever term you want to use, but production. Last year, he had 27 homers and 80 runs batted in. This year, Royals catchers are dead last in homers, dead last in runs batted in. That's a pretty big void left by his absence.
And plus, Perez is an outstanding thrower.
Yeah.
Controlling the running game as well.
1-2 pitch. Foul back.
But, I mean, this is what Kansas City has to do until they get him back. You know, they wanted to move their catcher that they had.
And Martin
Maldonado.
Wasn't exactly set the world on fire either.
But he was defensively okay, but this is the young man that's going to get a break. I remember this kid. He had a few games against us last September when they called him up, and I'll tell you, he swung the bat pretty well against us in that one series that I can remember.
Swung out and missed. Bieber strikes him out, and he comes right back. Retires the Royals in order here in the second. We are tied at one.
Drivers with discounts on car insurance.
Right.
up on the, you know, on his very first outing as a Cleveland Indian. The 1-2 pitch.
Oh.
I still remember, I don't believe you and I were doing the game, but there was a fan in Kansas City jumped out of the seats in left field. He landed on the warning track and snapped his leg.
Yeah.
Down there, left field
ball. Down left field.
Yeah.
Why is this guy jumping out of the stands?
The last time he did, it didn't work out well. Not for him. I also remember another unfortunate incident. John Smiley was in Kansas City.
Oh, boy.
He was warming up on the bump and broke his arm. Was it the 90s, wasn't
yeah.
it? In 97. 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Kick this. Goes down 2 away.
Fiddlestick.
First strikeout from Montgomery. Alex Gordon's had a couple of misadventures against the truck. Remember when he was still at third base last game of the season, put a ground ball right off the nose. We talked about. And then when he was on left field in Kansas City, he went back on a ball and knocked his head into the fence.
Kipnis inside the park home run.
That's right. Knocked him out of the game.
And then Kipnis in his 100th home run in Kansas City down the right field line.
Off the wall. We could go on and on, but we'll stop. Your point is well taken, man.
Sorry about that.
Roberto Perez, a room service hop. The Indians go in order. We played two, we have tied one. What's the difference between good and great? Good tries to get it right every time. Great actually does. With Clip Notes, we save your haircut details so you always get exactly the look you want. Great clips. It'd be great.
Kansas City Royals. That's right. The Cleveland Indians team against the Kansas City Royals. Go Cleveland.
All the way out of the box and right into second base and forcing to make a good play.
good start now in the third. First and third, nobody out. When you consider that Kansas City is 26 games under 500, the fact that they're ninth in the majors with runners in scoring position is a pretty good accomplishment. And against the Indians, they're even better. They've hit 324 as a team with runners in scoring position against Cleveland. Hunter Dozier struck out in the first. And a swing and a miss at a breaking ball.
Yeah, this is a pretty good hitting team. You got to make good pitches. They've never been a team that walks a lot. They have 280 on the year. That's 12th in the league. They go up there to hit.
Here it is, the Cleveland Indians team against the Kansas City Royals. That's right, the Cleveland Indians team against the Kansas City Royals. Go Cleveland!